Hey everybody, welcome back to the Star Wars headquarters, and DICE just revealed all the details about the roadmap for Star Wars Battlefront 2, including the fact that, get this, we'll be getting 3 new Capital Supremacy maps within the next 3 months. And then also, they are going to be doing a complete rework of Heroes vs. Villains mode as well. And then tomorrow, we're getting a hotfix for Battlefront 2 that will be fixing a lot of issues, including the spawning issue and balancing out Anakin and so much more. So, let's go over all of these details. Hit that like button if you are excited for these upcoming details. Let's go for 3,000 likes. So, we're going to start off with the roadmap, of course. And this is no April Fool's joke. This is the real deal, everybody. And this was posted on the official Battlefront 2 website. We're going to start off with April, which says there will be an additional location added in April to Capital Supremacy. Now, when we click into this, it says an existing Star Wars Battlefront 2 Clone Wars era planetary location is added to the Capital Supremacy game mode. So it is confirmed that the next location will indeed be a Clone Wars era location, but we don't know exactly which planet will be arriving in April. If we move on to May, they also list an additional location as well. It says the exact same thing here. It doesn't give the exact details on what the planet is, but we do know in May, we will also be getting yet another Clone Wars era planet. And then if we click here, there's a Heroes versus Villains core mechanics rework, and it says the core mechanics of the Heroes versus Villains game mode are changed, including the removal of the target system. So that is very exciting news for sure, because as you know, I have been wanting to see the removal of the target system for some time now, and I know that many of you agree with this, so I cannot wait to see what their plans are exactly for Heroes versus Villains mode. Now, if we go on to June, it says Capital Supremacy will be receiving an additional location in June as well, with the same text yet again explaining that this location will indeed be the third, or I guess technically the fourth, Clone Wars planet added to Capital Supremacy. And I did want to say that I was hoping to see a brand new location added to Capital Supremacy by June, a map like Coruscant or maybe Utapau, but it looks like these are all going to be existing Star Wars Battlefront 2 Clone Wars era planets that are already in the game. So hopefully after June, they add some new locations like Coruscant or Utapau to Capital Supremacy. We'll have to see. So there's a lot of news that we went over there, and you know, just to make sure I mention this, with that roadmap, it's always changing. So the community manager pointed this out. He said, keep in mind that the roadmap is a living document. Things can and will be added when the time is right. The ARC and Commando droid weren't on there originally. So, you know, you'll notice if you look at the roadmap, there were not any new reinforcements mentioned. So, you know, a lot of people were like, hey, where are the new reinforcements? So I'm really hoping they add new reinforcements to the roadmap soon. And, you know, I really want to see reinforcements like the Republic Commando or the Droidica added in there. So we'll have to see what they have planned, and hopefully they do add some new reinforcements in there very soon. And if they do, we'll let you know. So don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications right here at the Star Wars headquarters. Now, let's move on to the hotfix, because they did post all of the details for the upcoming hotfix, which is releasing tomorrow. And I'm going to read off all of this here because it is all important and we don't want to miss anything in this hotfix. So it says, hey everyone, it's always a nervous time within the team when a big new piece of content leaves the safety of the team and finds its way into your hands. We always felt that Capital Supremacy was shaping up to be a great addition to Star Wars Battlefront 2, and we've been really happy with the feedback we've had so far. In this hotfix, we've got some changes going live that will address game stability. One of the biggest issues we've been targeting has been when you find yourself stuck on the deploy screen within the second phase transition of Capital Supremacy. We've added some fail-safes, which we believe will lower the risk of this from happening, and will be monitoring the situation closely. It then goes on to explain some stuff about the AI. So let's go and read that off. So it says, the AI in Capital Supremacy is a brand new system and is located online or server side. We believe they were causing some of the crashes we were seeing and have added some fixes we believe should address this issue. Anakin Skywalker has had a minor balancing pass affecting the damage and cooldown values of his abilities. We felt that while being the chosen one, he needed some minor changes in order to try and bring balance. And then it goes on to say, reception to the new reinforcements has been really good, and we've got some tweaks that are being included based on your feedback. We've lowered the damage slightly of Power Blast while raising the end damage of the E5, which of course is the blaster of the Commando Droid. So that's really good news. Now, they go on to say, as always, please do keep your feedback incoming. And then they do list all of the specific changes here, which I am going to go over for you all because a lot of this stuff is very important. But yeah, again, all of this is coming tomorrow. And let's start off with the beginning here, where it does say they added failsafe scripts to reduce the chance of unreactive spawning when transitioning between ground and capital ship phases in Capital Supremacy. Additional server logging has been implemented to further diagnose potential spawning issues. They then said added tentative fixes for online AI causing server crashes on Capital Supremacy. We already know that. And they fixed a rendering issue that would cause the client to crash. So that's good news. Now, in regard to the exact balancing details for Anakin Skywalker, let's go over those right now. So it looks like they reduced retribution choke damage from 86 to 75 points per second. They reduced retribution push damage from 80 to 75 points per second. They reduced passionate strike first damage from 50 to 40, and then reduced passionate strike last damage from 150 to 130, and then increased passionate strike cooldown from 12 to 13, and then they reduced heroic might base damage from 100 to 70. So that's really good news. So hopefully it's enough. We'll see if that's enough of a reduction for Anakin Skywalker to be a legit nerf for him, because again, he can be very annoying to go up against in Capital Supremacy. So I really hope this all makes a difference. So we'll have to see. Now, they also mentioned the exact balance changes to the infiltrator weapons right here. So we're going to go over that right now. So it says the following. So they lowered power blast damage from 150 to 140 to prevent one-hit kills against assault, officer, and specialist classes. They raised the E5 blaster end damage from 21 to 30 to increase the weapon's effective range. So that's really good news. And then they fixed an issue where players who join an ongoing match would occasionally get no audio during the boarding cinematic in Capital Supremacy. They also fixed an issue that would prevent the ARC Trooper from gaining progress when playing on Phase 1 maps, which includes Kamino and Geonosis. So that's very interesting. Now, there's other details here as well, which I can go over real quick for all of you. So it says, fix an issue where Darth Maul's chokehold ability would occasionally be inaccurately activated from a distance when being used at the same time as another hero's ability. They also fixed some other issues here as well, which I believe you can go over by looking at the actual community transmission. So I'm not going to go over all of these. These are smaller issues, but there it is. There are all of the patch notes for tomorrow's hotfix. Definitely excited for it. I know that many of you have been having problems spawning in Capital Supremacy on the console. So hopefully that issue is 100% fixed by tomorrow or tomorrow. So that's really good news. Now, there's some other details that I did want to go over with you all really quick. So if you didn't get to play the triple XP that was going on over the weekend, This question was asked by a user by the name of Butter Toast, I think it is. They said, "Hey Ben, is it possible for you to extend the triple XP weekend for Capital Supremacy, as many, including myself, can hardly ever load into the game because of the lobby spawn bug? Much appreciated." And Ben responded and said, "No promises, but we'll see if we can do triple XP again in the not so distant future. I'd like to do it, yes." So hopefully, you know, they do another triple XP, you know, for those who didn't really get to experience it because of the spawn bug issue. Now, also, one other thing to mention about the AI. So, Ben also mentioned, just a note regarding our AI players or autoboys or autobots. The current plan is to gauge the hotfix for stability for 24 hours once it has gone live. From here, we will look at turning the AI back on for Capital Supremacy. So they're going to be turning on, I guess, a little bit after the hotfix, if I'm not mistaken. Now, with the ARC Trooper, 1010 had a really interesting point about the ARC Trooper. They said, "Can I also suggest to make each gun automatic while keeping the ROF the same, of course? Spamming both triggers so fast feels terrible to use, especially on PC, where clicking both buttons will negatively affect your aim. Guns with high fire rates should not be single fire." So that's a really good point, because I also have that problem on PC. It feels really awkward when you're trying to, you know, use both the left and the right mouse buttons. I mentioned this in a previous video, and Jay responded and said, "Interesting. Not sure if this is possible, but I'll bring it up. I think it'd be cool as an option in the game." So I think they should have an option within the controls that says bind dual wielding weapons to one button, like the left click on the mouse. I think that should be an option within the game, you know, for players that find it awkward, like myself, when using both the left click and the right click for dual wielding pistols. So hopefully they listened to that. I think that was a really good idea. But to wrap up the video, I did want to mention this one last thing. Jedi Fallen Order, remember, it is arriving to Star Wars Celebration on Saturday, April 13th. And Jay posted this. He said, "The past few weeks have been a whirlwind of writing, feedbacking, editing, and coordination in preparation for Star Wars Celebration, and I love it. Now we're under 2 weeks away from the reveal for Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order, and I can't wait for you all to see this game." So as a reminder, make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications to us right here at the Star Wars headquarters. We're going to be covering Jedi Fallen Order's reveal, which again is on Saturday, April 13th. So we're hoping for a full-blown trailer, and we'll be doing a full breakdown of this trailer once it arrives. So again, don't forget to subscribe, turn on notifications. But there it is. I know it was a longer video. I apologize about that, but there's a lot of stuff to go over in this video. If you enjoyed it, hit that like button. We'll be back with more Battlefront 2 and Jedi Fallen Order news, as well as movie news as well. I'll see you next time, and may the Force be with you, always. What?